to the Veg Expo video where I'll just show you guys everything that I got, my haul, and I'll do a taste test at the same time. So then I actually know if the stuff is good that I got. So I'm going to start with this. So Veg Expo had a whole bunch of Miyoko's. I think they had almost the whole line. But like the three that I really wanted to try, they didn't have anymore. I wanted to try the Smoked Farmhouse or the Sharp Farmhouse. Or there was one other one, but I don't remember what it's called. But anyways, this one apparently is really popular, so let's try it. It smells really good. I had a tiny, like, taste at the expo, but it was, like, the size of a pea, so I couldn't really taste it. I'm just going to have it on a Mary's cracker. It's actually pretty mild, but I really like the sun-dried tomato in it. I'll just try it by itself. The texture is awesome. It's really, really creamy. It's got the perfect amount of tang. So, really, this is one of the best... This is one of the best brands out there that we can get in Canada anyways. There's a lot of other ones in the US, and look for your local people making these cheeses because they're just artisan vegan cheeses. And if you're having any issues with giving up dairy or transitioning over, these are the best things to do. They're expensive, but they're so worth it. I've been wanting to try this forever. I couldn't find the gluten-free one. So I am trying this one. It is non-GMO wheat, so I can digest it. It's not so bad. But if you want the gluten-free one, it is available. I think it's only available in the U.S., which sucks. But I used to be a huge fan of the white cheddar mac and cheeses. So grab a fork. And that's what it looks like. I don't know if you guys can see that. Alright. So I prepared the noodles according to the package. I didn't use Earthbounds because I don't have any. And I didn't use plant milk. I just used the pasta water. But it's still... It smells really similar to the other one. So I did do a review of the gluten-free noodles with the regular cheddar sauce. So I'll link that below if you guys want to see it. Still really hot. I like this one way better. So it's not very strong. I guess with the Earth Balance, it would give it a much more prominent flavor. The noodles are a little bit. The noodles are way better, but I mean, they're wheat, so, but I think they can really work on their gluten-free noodles. I'm so excited. I've heard these are not as cheesy as Cheez-Its, but they're basically the same thing. Let's see. Again, this was from Vegan Supply. I'm obsessed with them. I don't think that shows. Alright. Oh, that opened really easily. Just pulled on it. Okay. That's what it looks like. It smells cheesy. These are really good. I would definitely buy these again. What are they made of? Hmm. It's like 1,000 ingredients. But this is just the kind of stuff that you can eat, or if you want to eat now and again, if you're following a healthy vegan diet. But if you just want to be vegan for the ethical reasons and the environmental reasons, man, go all over this. Because it's a good replacement. It means that you don't... It's not even a replacement. It stands by itself. Where you just, like, just eat this instead. I'm gonna try this. So this, I've heard a million people talk about it. I was really excited when they had it there. I did used to love yogurt. Am I supposed to shake it? I'm gonna take a real taste. Okay. Mix it. So it's really good at first. At the first taste you get like the fruit and the sweetness and the creaminess, and then it has this weird taste to it. Let me taste again. I want to like it. Nope. Ugh. It starts off great. It starts off on, like, these awesome notes, and then it just goes bad. Like, it has a really bad, it's not even an aftertaste, it's more like a mid-taste. Like, right in the middle. Nope. So, I won't be buying that again. So, I got these really awesome samples from this company called West Point Naturals? Yeah. So they do bulk foods and stuff, which I'll probably be using them for my meal delivery service, Purple Radish Kitchen. I'll probably be using them for my bulk dry needs and stuff. They seem really awesome. They seem really vegan-minded. So these are vegan candies that they have. So they have peach rings and fruit bears. And I'm a big fan, or was a big fan of peach rings, but they're not vegan because they have gelatin in them. These are vegan. Oh wait, these are the gummy bears. Okay, let's start gummy bears. They're so cute. Sorry, my nails are so purple. A little tiny kind of bear-ish. They have sugar on them. These are good. They're organic. Eugenics. These are as good as the gummy bears. They're definitely a win. Let's see. It's a peach ring. What is that? Looks like there's tapioca starch right there. But it's okay. It doesn't smell like anything. The taste is right on. It's exactly like a peach cocktail, like a peach ring, whatever. The texture is not quite the same. It's not as chewy. It's more like pectin-y. Awesome. And this is going to be the last of the food stuff, and I'll show you the other stuff that I got. But I got these. So, anyways, yeah, I would definitely recommend getting these. They're so good. Got these. Pea Knot Cups by No Way Foods. I've had some of their other stuff. I have not had these yet. So, oh, cool. And it says, it's vegan approved. No artificial colors or flavors. I like that. So it's made with, okay, sugar, cocoa butter, cocoa mass, sunflower seed,
roasted sunflower seed, maltodextrin, sunflower lecithin, blah, 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 vanilla. Okay.
So I've done sunflower seed butter in a lot of stuff because I do avoid peanuts for the most part. I do use some PB2 now and again, but really, I try not to. I just smell everything. So that's what the peanut butter cup looks like. My dog is eyeing this like crazy.
It's not as creamy. Wait. I want to have more.
So, it's not super chocolatey. You get like that little salty taste at the end, whereas usually in a peanut butter cup you'll get the salty in with the peanut butter at the same time. But they're decent. I would definitely buy these again. Alright, so that's it for the food stuffs. I'm going to finish my macaroni and then I'll show you guys the rest of the stuff I got. A little background before I go into these next things that I got. I don't really take a lot of supplements, but I do have issues with anxiety and stuff like that. And I also really like stuff that's going to boost my training, while being obviously a natural whole food. So I don't do any supplements other than B12 because I am deficient. Long story short, I don't have an intrinsic factor. So it has nothing to do with being vegan. I was B12 deficient before. But this stuff, so these, I got two different ways to take it. Although this company is based in Victoria, so it's a BC, Canada-owned company, which is awesome. And it's basically their most popular product with five different mushrooms. So in this, there is reishi, which I was already taking, cordyceps, wait, that's in French. Reishi, cordyceps, turkey tail, lion's mane, and chaga. So there's a bunch of different benefits to every one of those. I was taking reishi a lot because it is an autoimmune system, or an immune system, sorry, booster, and it was really, really good for my anxiety. So it kind of like zens you out and keeps you a bit more calm. For me, it's mostly in social situations and stuff like that, so I do tend to take it pretty much every day just to like keep it going. So I chose to get the powder and the tincture because the powder is easy to do when you're doing smoothies every day and stuff like that, which I am going to start doing, but the tincture is really great for just taking it regardless. But I'll show you guys what it looks like. I can do a separate video on mushrooms if you guys want. So it's super dark. This stuff tastes pretty earthy. It's pretty potent, but it's really good for you, and these guys were really awesome. He did a presentation, so I'll put a link below to the company on there, and if you guys do want to see a video on mushrooms themselves and their benefits and stuff like that and why I take them, comment below, and I will do that next week. So that was my whole haul and taste test from Veg Expo. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And let me know if you guys have any products you want me to try, or if there's, you know, if you have any comments on the stuff that I tried and if you liked it or not. So basically, really, the only thing I really didn't like was the yogurt. Yeah. Bad. Just, no. So everything else was really awesome, and I will see you guys in another video. So if you enjoyed it, just give it a like. And you can subscribe to my channel for more. Bye.